స్వామి శరణం. శ్రీ శబరిమల అయ్యప్ప టెంపుల్ వర్షిప్ ఇస్ అ ఫైన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ హౌ టెంపుల్ వర్షిప్ యాజ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ సనాతన ధర్మ క్యాన్ లీడ్ ఆల్ మెన్ అండ్ విమెన్ టు సాల్వేషన్ టు ఎన్లైట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ దియర్ సోల్ బై అబ్జర్వింగ్ ద వ్రత్ ఆఫ్ 41 డేస్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ శబరిమల హౌ మెన్ అండ్ విమెన్ క్యాన్ రీచ్ వేరియస్ స్టేజెస్ ఆఫ్ అటైనింగ్ వైరాగ్య జ్ఞాన భక్తి అండ్ అల్టిమేట్లీ బికమ్ వన్ విత్ గాడ్ తత్వం అసి. శబరిమల టెంపుల్ ఇస్ ది మోస్ట్ ఫేమస్ టెంపుల్ ఇన్ ది స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ కేరళ అండ్ ప్రాబబ్లీ ఇన్ సౌత్ ఇండియా. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ మిలియన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫాలోయర్స్ అక్రాస్ ద వరల్డ్. పర్టికులర్లీ వీ సీ మిలియన్స్ ఆఫ్ సౌత్ ఇండియన్స్ కమింగ్ టు శబరిమల mainly during the mandala and makara vilak season and also during the monthly puja season. The majority judgment of the Honourable Supreme Court of India's constitutional bench, which was delivered on 28th September 2018, came as a huge shock for many of the believers in the traditional Ayappa temple. We have seen men and particularly women of all ages coming down the streets and voicing their concerns and protests. They have come in hundreds of thousands, and these protesters so far have been very, very peaceful. They were all praying that the matter be reviewed by the Honorable Supreme Court of India. And on the 13th of November, Honorable Supreme Court of India has, by an order, stated that the matter will be heard at length on the 22nd January 2019. But Honorable Supreme Court of India has not stayed the operation of its judgment of 28th September. Now, one wonders if women between 10 and 50 years of age, can they go to the temple and have darshan, because Honorable Supreme Court of India has not stayed its judgment of 28th. I would like to state here that one of the points raised by the learned counsels who have filed the review petitions is that Honorable Supreme Court of India considered as two of its five main points Rule 3 of the Kerala Public Places Temple Entry Authorization Act, whereas the rule that would apply to all Travancore temples, including Sabarimala temple, would be the 1952 rules that were framed under the Kerala Travancore Cochin Temple Entry Authorization Act of 1950. In the first place, these lawyers believe that a wrong rule of a wrong act has been discussed and has been struck down as unconstitutional. That Rule 3B had nothing to do with Sabarimala temple. The rule that applies, or the similar rule that applies in the case of Sabarimala temple, is Rule 6C of the Travancore Cochin Temple Entry Authorization Act and rules made thereunder. Therefore, since the 6C rule continues to be in force and is the rule framed by the Devaswom Board itself, Devaswom Board has a mandatory duty, bounden duty, to ensure that the rule is not violated and women between the age 10 and 50 are still not allowed to the temple. Second, the religious character of Sri Ayappa enshrined in Sri Sabarimala temple is that of a Naishtika Brahmachari, an eternal Brahmachari. In temples where the Devata is a Naishtika Brahmachari, it is common practice that women of certain age or women of all age are not allowed to come and worship. This is the situation in all Naishtika Brahmachari temples, and it is found across India. The major case which discussed this point and the entry of women of all ages was the case called Mahendran's case that took place in 1991 before the Honorable Division Bench of the Kerala High Court. There, the Honorable Division Bench had checked with the religious authorities, namely the Tantri of Sabarimala temple and other Tantris and other scholars of Shastras, and concluded that the religious character of Ayappa is that of a Naishthika Brahmachari, and that is why women of certain age are not allowed to come and worship in the temple. That finding has attained finality. Honourable Supreme Court has not set it aside. Honourable Supreme Court has not said the religious character of Sri Ayappa as enshrined in Sabarimala temple is not that of a Naishthika Brahmachari. It has not said so. So what transpires in such a case is the religious character of a place of worship which was there on 15th August 1947, it has to continue as before, as it was on 15th August 1947. This is very clearly made out by a statute called the Places of Worship Special Provisions Act. This is a central act, and section 4.1 of the said act clearly says the religious character of a place of worship shall continue to be what it was on 15th August 1947. So if a judgment of any court, including the Supreme Court, has the possibility of violating a statute which is still in force and which has not been declared unconstitutional or void, then the judgment necessarily has to be re-looked at, and a violation of a statute should not take place. In this case, this is a very salutary provision. This act was brought by the Congress government to ensure that there are no more disputes beyond Ram Mandir Babri Masjid dispute. Now the religious character of Sri Ayappa temple in Sabarimala on 15th August 1947 was that of a Naishthika Brahmachari. So if women between 10 and 50 are allowed to have darshan there, it will definitely dilute the religious character or even do away with it. And that is the belief of millions of Ayappa devotees. Third, in any religious matter in Kerala temples and in Travancore temples, including Sri Sabarimala temple, the Tantri is the final authority. What he says, what he expounds from the Shastras is the final word. And it is the bounden duty of the Devaswom Board, Travancore Devaswom Board, to take instructions from the Tantri regarding religious matters. The Travancore Devaswom Board manages the properties and the affairs of the Travancore temples, and it can do so only as per the custom and usage of such temples. It has to arrange for conduct of pujas and festivals. It cannot conduct the pujas and festivals directly. It cannot run the temple. It can only manage the properties of the temple. As far as the Kerala government is concerned, they have no authority, absolutely no authority, to interfere in any of the affairs of the temple, including the so-called secular affairs. As far as religious affairs, even the Devaswom Board has no authority. But when we talk about the Kerala government, we must remember they have nothing, nothing at all to say regarding the temple or to interfere in the affairs of the temple. Therefore, it makes immense sense that since the Honourable Supreme Court of India is going to have a re-look at its judgment, and since Rule 6C of the Travancore Cochin Temple Entry Authorization Act is still valid, and therefore Devaswom Board should ensure that that rule is not violated, its own rule is not violated, and it should seek the Tantri's guidance and instructions in religious matters, since the judgment of the Honourable Supreme Court of India is in variance of the custom and tradition of the temple. They should necessarily consult senior counsels and file a review petition. We hope Lord Ayappa bestows better sense on the authorities and on the government officials to ensure that no custom and tradition are violated. Thank you very much. Swami Sharanam.